For the past 14 years, WNEP-TV has been a proud sponsor of Team Allied Services and you, a team of volunteers who raise hundreds of thousands of dollars for Allied Services Integrated Health Systems by fundraising and running the TCS New York City Marathon.
Allied Services provides rehab for stroke survivors, firsts for children with developmental disabilities, precious moments for hospice patients, and more. This year, our coverage of the campaign was taken up a notch with the incorporation of digital media and one other thing.
I will be joining the team this year. I'm running my first ever marathon on November 5th. So we really need all of your support, both in donations and emotionally as well.
So like years past, we told stories of success at Allied Services. Our viewers made possible with their donations in previous years, like this one.
And 2 feet and jump.
Doctors didn't think Liam would walk, let alone dance.
And jump.
They gave us a picture. He may be wheelchair bound for life and didn't know where his cognitive skills would lead. However, he's thriving, he's happy, and he loves coming here.
Okay, just find your balance.
Liam's been coming to Allied Services in Wilkes-Barre for physical therapy since he was 2. He's now 7 and has far surpassed his doctor's initial expectations.
Very good job. Oh, heels down, please.
Liam suffered a stroke shortly after birth, which led to cerebral palsy that affects his right side.
Pick up a shoe on.
His short life has been filled with surgeries and specialist appointments.
Go, Liam, go.
This weekly therapy appointment is a welcome reprieve for parents Kristen and Bill.
He's a frequent flyer of Philadelphia to get many specialists, neurology, cardiology, pediatric, development, etc. And he was eligible for physical therapy down there as well. However, coming here and just the 15-minute jaunt made it a lot quicker. We're at Philadelphia enough. And so this makes our lives easier by far.
Kristen calls Liam's therapist, Jean Bohannon, a miracle worker.
Look at me. Heal. Thank you. Let's go. Heal. 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 Thank you. Oh, you are trying so hard. Should we stretch first?
These two have been working together for years.
Do you want to go on the rock wall today?
Yeah.
Yeah? Okay.
Hold and on. Jean loves seeing how far Liam has come.
Ready? Feet on green. For Liam, you know, he was very shy when he was really little. He was really clingy to mom. He didn't want to separate. And now to see him run down the hall and want to come to therapy and not be afraid and just be willing to jump in and try new things is wonderful to see.
Good work today, right?
All Liam wants is to try new things and keep up with his 2 big brothers.
He's very stubborn.
Yes.
Very stubborn. He wants to be able to do what he can for himself.
Are you ready for this hand to have a turn?
And the therapists and Allied are going to make sure it's all possible for him.
There's a turtle. He's swimming. He's swimming. I think the door's wide open for Liam, and I think whatever Liam wants to do, he'll be able to do. We may need to modify some things for him. Right now, he wants to be an altar boy, so we're working on figuring out ways that he can use both hands and be able to participate. So it's possible we just may need to modify some things.
You gonna show me your happy dance?
And that calls for a happy dance.
We also highlighted stories like Leo's.
I know I wouldn't be able to do it without everybody at Allied. They literally helped me get all my strength back, my walking, my balancing. They pretty much taught me how to re-walk.
Emmys.
And an Emmy prior to getting into the trek, so if I held him up, I could get maybe 3 or 5 steps before he wanted to drop and crawl, and he would cry. Now he wants to hold my hands. He's walking 30 steps on his own when we come out of the trek, so.
And Evie.
There's a few different types of spina bifida. Evie's is called myelomeningocele, so it's unfortunately the worst form of spina bifida, meaning the spinal cord and the nerves actually grow outside of the body with no protection.
Despite that, at 16 months old, Evie began to walk on her own. She's continued to defy the odds with the help of Allied Services Pediatric Department.
Don't get too dizzy.
And while other members of the Newswatch 16 team told these stories, I showed our viewers a side of the campaign they had never seen before.
It's part of my long training run for the week.
Taking our audience with me through the entire marathon training process on digital media platforms.
We had to pay tribute to those lost on 9/11 this morning. Then we went to the Back Mountain and learned all about the storm damage and the recovery and the costly repairs that are going to take place there. Then I had to edit the handbells for Check It Out with Chelsea, but guess what, guys? Still managed to get in 7 miles for Team Allied, even if I had to use my watch flashlight.
Including the good, like my training schedule and triumphs along the way and moments of fun. As well as the motivation behind the campaign. Then there was the bad, like the hardships of the training.
Okay, 6 miles in. I'm gonna try this through. They said try it out before the marathon.
And the donation requests that seemed to get monotonous, but well worth it.
Support it. Come on, right here. I'm so close to my goal, guys. I'm so close.
And even the ugly. When a fall during a training run sent me to the ER and threw a wrench right in my training schedule.
First of all, I just want to thank everybody because you guys are so nice in my comments on my story here and then on my Facebook post. It's really not that bad. I probably made a big deal out of it because it was my first ambulance ride, the first time I ever had stitches, the first time I fell down on the pavement and got up and blood was everywhere. So it was very scary. But also, I just want to say thank you to everybody. So I was just running on the sidewalk and tripped. I don't know what happened. But I landed like on my hand and then on my chin. And I have 3 stitches in there. I don't know. Is this upsetting to some viewers? Sorry. And I like got up and this other runner asked me if I was okay. And I was like, no, like it hurts. I can't move my neck. So I called 911 and then former mayor 44, Andy Tzinski pulls over. He gets out of his car. He's got gloves. He's got napkins and he got on 911. He was like, County, I'm here. I'm going to apply pressure until you get here. And I just couldn't really move my neck and my head. He told me not to. I could, and I tried, and I was trying to take pictures, and he was like, stop taking pictures. And I'm like, you don't understand. This is what happens when trauma happens. My camera comes out. It's just a reflex. I'm crying. There's snot everywhere.
But with the viewer's support and encouragement, we got right back on that horse and ultimately completed the TCS New York City Marathon. Don't worry. Newswatch 16 brought our audience along for that ride, too, from the start.
Good evening, everybody. Newswatch 16's Chelsea Strub here inside the Javits Center in downtown Manhattan. And by this time tomorrow, some of us, members from Team Allied Services and you, will have completed the New York City Marathon. But the first step was to stop here at the Expo to get ready for race day. More than 50,000 runners have spent the last 2 days coming to the Javits Center to get all of their race day essentials, including their bibs, their shirts. They have to come here and find their name on the giant wall of all the participants and check out the booths to get any last minute supplies they may need. Speaking of home, that's why we do this. We have come here to run this race and raise money to benefit everyone in northeastern and central Pennsylvania benefited by Allied Services, especially those in the pediatric unit.
All of our team here, we're here with Team Allied Services, and that's what it's all about. We've been fundraising for the last several months, and it's all about helping people in our area, rehab centers, everything that we can do goes back to Allied Services. All of the fundraisers, the events, the online sales, everything's all about Team Allied Services.
I love New York. I love the cause. I love running. I love the team. I love it all. So this is my kid's first time doing it, meaning coming to actual New York to see the marathon, so I'm excited.
There's been a lot of camaraderie amongst the runners. We've gotten together for group runs. We all know each other, and it's been fun. We're going to get together tomorrow, and we're going to run 26.2 miles with our best friends.
Okay, guys, wish us luck. We hope you are following us along. We'll check in with you on later editions of Newswatch 16, and you can see how we did. Yeah. We're excited. We're kind of nervous, but mostly excited. Chelsea Strub, Newswatch 16, reporting from New York City.
And to the finish line.
I'm not going to lie to you. I'm in a lot of pain. But most of that pain is in my face for smiling for 4.5 hours, because that's all I could do as I ran this New York City Marathon. It all started this morning at 5 a.m. in Staten Island and continued from there. Then we ran through almost all of Brooklyn, and it was like running through a 10-mile block party. Music, thousands of people lining the course, cheering us on. And after that, we went through Queens and across the Queensboro Bridge and through Manhattan, where the party continued. More than 50,000 runners from all over the world were on this course. 131 countries were represented. I saw runners from Indonesia, Germany, and South America, you name it. And then we went through the Bronx, back to Manhattan, through Central Park, where we crossed the finish line. Now the training was brutal, and I'm a little bit salty. I'll have Corey zoom in on the salt on my forehead there. But I have to tell you, the feeling I have now after completing the New York City Marathon, getting this medal, and doing this all for Team Allied Services and you really makes it worth it. We can't wait until Thursday for the finale to show you guys how much we've raised for Allied Services. We're also gonna have a special edition of Check It Out with Chelsea on Thursday night, and I'm gonna show you all the sights and sounds of the New York City Marathon then. Chelsea Strub, Newswatch 16, reporting from New York City.
For the first time in 14 years of the campaign, we showed our audience what it's like to balance work, fundraising, and training, all on digital platforms, so they could get a new understanding of just how much goes into the campaign and what training for a marathon is like.
Plus, for the first time, we showed our audience a first-person view of the TCS New York City Marathon, expanding on something that we've been doing for more than a decade and making it new again on a special edition of a weekly segment.
We talk a lot about the New York City Marathon this time of year because Team Allied Services and you participates in order to raise thousands of dollars for folks in northeastern Pennsylvania served by Allied Services. But we've never given a firsthand point of view of the entire race. NewsOne 16's Chelsea Strub joins us now from Motor World in Plains Township with all of Team Allied Services and you fresh off that marathon. Hey, Chelsea.
Hey, Stacy. How are you? We're feeling good. Woo! Excellent. We're feeling really good. We're still on that runner's high from the marathon. I think a lot of us are still in a daze. If you ask us, hey, are we going to do it again? We're not ready to make that decision just yet. But if any of you are thinking about doing the TCS New York City Marathon with Allied Services next year, I have a special edition of Check It Out with Chelsea for you.
Preparing for the TCS New York City Marathon takes months of training. That might include some bumps along the way, but when the day finally comes, it's out the door of your hotel room at 5 a.m. and onto a bus with other runners taking part on behalf of charities from around the world. We all watch the sunrise over the same bridge we'll soon run across. When we arrive in Staten Island, we're separated into different groups. Here, we meet up with other runners from Team Allied Services and you.
I can tell you we are going to have a beautiful day today. Everyone's going to finish. Everyone's going to have a great day.
40 minutes before our start time, we are sent to our corrals and given instructions. Then we head to the starting line with thousands of other runners. Have a little dance party, honor our country, and our host.
The anticipation mounts here at the start.
And then. The first 2 miles take us over the Verrazano Bridge. Then we're in Brooklyn for the next 11 miles, where we see nonstop action from people on the sidewalks cheering us on, celebrating our hard work from top to bottom.
Water, 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 water.
We had our first hydration station here too.
It was a nonstop party featuring music, costumes, even animals.
I really cannot emphasize enough the impact the energy from this crowd has on your momentum as you continue to push to the halfway mark. Before a quick 3 miles through Queens. Then the sounds of cheering stops as you cross over what feels like a very steep Queensboro Bridge and loop around into Manhattan. Mile 16 is where I was lucky enough to have more than a dozen family members waiting for me with hugs and motivation to get me through the last 10 miles that continue through Manhattan and go over another bridge into the Bronx, We lost some energy in the Bronx, but picked it right back up as we crossed our final bridge and ran into our founding member of Team Allied Services and you.
How's it going, Steve?
I feel beautiful.
You feel beautiful?
Yeah.
Looking
we're
good?
We're flying.
Then it's back into Manhattan for another 2 miles and into Central Park. That was packed with support.
Come on, Chelsea!
My name was written on my arm and hundreds of people screamed it, which truly helped me get across the finish line.
We did it, all of us. Chelsea Strub, Newswatch 16, reporting from the finish line of the New York City Marathon. And I wasn't the only one that crossed the finish line. All of us did. Excellent. It was a long road, a lot of training, but overall, a great experience, right, guys?
Amazing.
Absolutely. All right, well, we're going to check in with you a little bit later at 5 o'clock. We've got a special surprise for you coming up on Newswatch 16 at 5.
We Chelsea love Strub, surprises.
Newswatch 16 reporting live in Luzerne County.
Thanks, Chelsea. Yep. Thanks so much, and congratulations to the entire team there.
And then, of course, how it pays off.
That's right. Good evening, Lisa and Scott. This is the moment we've all been waiting for, and hopefully you guys have... because it's been a long few months here. We've worked really hard, and now we're going to see that all pay off, okay? So I'm going to count it down, and you guys are going to lift up the cloth, okay? 3, 2, 1. Wow! Amazing! $465,272 raised this year from all of us and all of our major sponsors and people like you at home who came to the events, who commented on our posts, who donated to our pages. Thank you so much. We have Bill Conaboy here, CEO and President of Allied Services. What does this mean to you?
This is wonderful. And first, Chelsea, thank you for making the commitment to run. Thank you, all our runners. Thank you, all our sponsors, WNEP, everybody in this community. It's unbelievable. And the beautiful part is that all this stays right here in Northeast Central Pennsylvania. Take care of kids in our communities and families that need our services. They don't have to leave town. This is an enormous help. We couldn't do without you.
Right here. Yep. Right here at home. Everybody, round of applause. We are so excited.
But Chelsea, there's one more thing you have to do before we wrap it up tonight. Okay. You got to sign that check. That's our turn.
I have to sign it?
You got to sign that check.
Oh, boy. Here we go, guys. A lot of pressure here.
What should I sign? Team Ally?
Oh, nice.
You. Woo! I had to do cursive. I had to whip out the cursive. Guys, this money, like Bill Conaboy says, it stays right here in Northeastern and Central Pennsylvania and helps children and families at Allied Services. We've told you the stories before. You can go to WNEP.com and learn about some of the firsthand accounts. Evie, Liam, Leo, and listen to these stories and find out how the money we've raised through this campaign, the millions of dollars we've raised throughout the years in this campaign, impacts people right here in Northeastern and Central Pennsylvania. Lastly, we want to thank all of you. We want to thank all the sponsors. If you could just turn around for me, Aaron. We have all of the major sponsors for this campaign. We want to thank you so much for believing in us and for supporting us. And we want to thank all of you at home for going online, using your cell phones, texting the word Allied, texting the word RUN to 570-826-1616. It's meant so much. Thank you for all the kind words online and all of the support. We couldn't have done it without you. All right, guys, are we going to do this again next year? What do you think? All right, guys, probably going to do it next year. Chelsea Strub, Newswatch 16, reporting live in Luzerne County.
I'm Chelsea Strub. Thank you for your consideration.